Hey, it's me, Nicholas. Welcome to this video. Today I'm gonna revisit the GTX 750 by Nvidia. And no, don't worry, I'll not run benchmarks. I'll show you exactly at what settings this graphics card is running those modern games at, including the new Far Cry 5. This GPU was released in early 2014, so it's slightly over 4 years old now. It wasn't that great of a card back then, but it was a solid budget choice. But what about today? Is it even usable in 2018? Huge thanks goes out to Patrick, the talented guy behind the LEGO animation channel BrickMove. He sent me this 750 along with his CPU, motherboard and RAM. Awesome guy, check out his channel. Spec-wise, a not too impressive card. The TDP of just 55 watts and just 1 GB of VRAM pretty much tells it all. 2 GB is what I'd consider the absolute minimum for today's standards. But then again, what can we do with this particular GTX 750? As for the test system, I'm gonna use my trusty i7-7700K again. To mix things up a little, let's start with Far Cry 5 this time around. First, let's try to go high, that's 1080p for the resolution, with all the other settings at low, no AA either. And according to the game, we are already exceeding the available video memory. Obviously, it's not a greatest experience, 28fps on average. We'll have to lower the resolution down to something like 720p. Well, the graphics looks like, you know, but the frame rate is pretty decent. Now, we're looking at around 54fps now. Oh, and I probably should work on my shooting skills there. Let's go for a lighter game title now, namely GTA 5. Settings are 1080p, no AA, and lowest possible settings, aka normal. This actually gets us a fantastic frame rate of well over the 90fps mark on average, so it looks like we have some headroom there. I'm gonna crank the resolution up to 1440p now, and would you look at that? The game runs fairly smoothly, 63fps on average, that's nice. But what if you want nicer graphics? Well, now I'm back at 1080p, however did enable FXAA, 50% on these bars, and mostly high settings. Reflection MSAA is off, though. Keep in mind we are exceeding the VRAM once more, which could lead to sudden frame drops. But most of the time the game runs great with 57fps on average. Next up, Rise of the Tomb Raider, a pretty heavy title. Still, let's try out 1080p in the X11 mode, however, and the preset lowest, obviously. And surprisingly, the frame rate's looking not too bad. 44fps, not great, but manageable. But by lowering the resolution down to 720p, it's a whole different experience, framerate-wise. The graphics aren't looking good, but the average FPS sure does, 64. Let's take a look at Doom with the OpenGL API. Again, let's stick with 1080p at first. Unfortunately, I considered this to be a bad experience, quite laggy and stuttery, so I'm gonna lower the res all the way down to 720p. And while it is still not the optimal gaming experience, 40fps is what some people do consider playable after all. In Battlefield 1 at 1080p, the X11, and low settings, the game's running at like 43fps. At 900p, I like it much better since we're now in the 60s in terms of frame rate. Finally, The Witcher 3. It's known to be a demanding game, but I'm gonna try the impossible and go straight for 1080p low settings. And yeah, not all that bad, but 36fps on average is not something I'm too happy with. So let's give the good old 720p a shot again. Oh yeah, much better. 62fps. Unfortunately, the graphics quality is so low, the game doesn't look that enjoyable anymore. But yeah, while the GTX 750 is not the best performer nowadays, it wasn't even in 2014, it nonetheless does okay even in these AAA game titles. If you were to run esports titles such as CSGO and whatever else there is out there, you'd be perfectly fine, I guess. The GTX 750 is definitely a usable GPU to this day, especially since no extra power connector is required, not even power hungry. I think this card would be capable of more had it just an extra gigabyte more of video memory to work with. Once again, thanks a bunch to Patrick aka BrickMove for sending me this card. And with that said, thanks for watching, guys.